Today we will start chapter 10 circles. Circles already have studied many a times. Circle is defined as set of those points which are equidistant from a given point. If it is a given point, at equidistant from it, we will be having infinite points. Those all points together are called a circle. And the given point from which all the points are at equal distance is called center of circle. So the set of all points is circle. The distance between each point and the given point is called radius. Is called radius. If you draw a line segment passing through the center and the end points of line segment lying on the circle, then that line segment is called diameter. And you all know that diameter is 2 times radius. 2 times radius. Usually center is denoted by letter O. Radius is denoted by letter R, and diameter is denoted by letter D. You can also draw a line segment whose end points lie on the circle, like shown here, AB. Then AB is called chord. What is AB called as? Chord. You can extend AB and make it a line like this. PQ. It means that AB, A and B lie on line PQ. AB lie on line PQ. Now this PQ is called as secant of the circle. What PQ is called? PQ is secant of the circle. Then how do you define secant? Secant of the circle is defined as a line whose two points lie on the circle. Which two points lie on the circle? Now if you take down this PQ slowly, if PQ is take down slowly, then what will happen to AB? Can anyone tell me? If you start taking PQ slowly downward like this, you start taking it down slowly, not necessarily parallel, downward you say. What will happen? What happens to AB? Whether AB length increases or decreases? Yes, very good. If I take down slowly a PQ line, then the distance between A and B will go on decreasing, because when it comes down, the point A and B will also come down. A and B will also come down. A and B will also come down. After moving it down by some distance, A and B will coincide. A and B will coincide. That means secant PQ will touch the circle at only one point. It will not be intersecting the circle. Instead, it will be touching the circle. Okay. If secant touches the circle at only one point, then it is called as tangent. It is called as tangent. Tangents already have learned. You have constructed tangents. Okay. PQ is tangent. Tangent is a line that touches a circle, that touches a circle. At only one point. At only one point. The point common to the point common to circle and tangent. Circle and tangent is called as point of contact. Is called as point of contact. Finished. At a given point, on circle, only one tangent. Can be drawn, not more than one. Let us consider this circle here. Say this is given point. Touching this, I'll draw one tangent here. If I try to draw one more tangent, definitely that tangent will intersect the circle at two points. You can see here. Since circle is very small, you cannot differentiate. For that, I can take one more tangent like this. I'll try to draw one more tangent. At this point, if I try to draw one more tangent, it will not be possible. Only one tangent will be possible. If this is one, this is two, and this is three. What is one here? One is tangent. What are two and three? Can anyone tell? Secant. Right? Very good. Correct. Two and three are secant because they are intersecting circle at two different points here. But can you tell me for a circle at different points, how many tangents you can draw? Very Very good. Why it is so? Because for one point you can draw one tangent. Because for one point you can draw one tangent. A circle will be having infinite points. So for every point you can draw one tangent. Hence there will be infinite number of tangents. A circle can have infinite tangents. And have infinite tangents. Because circle consists of infinite points. Because circle consists of infinite points. So at every point you can draw one tangent. So now on whatever we have studied, based on that, whatever we have studied based on that, there is a theorem. This theorem already we used in construction chapter. Now you are going to learn the theorem. Theorem 10.1. The tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. Through the point of contact. Before we go for this theorem proof, I want to tell you some facts, right? Let us consider one point A and a line segment PQ and a line segment PQ. I will give you various points here like this. How many points have you given? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 points I have given. Now, if I ask you to measure distance between A and point 1, A and point 2, and so on up to A and point 8, what you will do? You will place your scale here. You will measure the distance. Again, place the scale here, measure the distance, and so on. Among these, which distance is shortest? Can you tell me? A4 is shortest. Very good, Dhiraj. Distance A4 is shortest. Okay, right. Then what is the angle between PQ and A4? Angle between PQ and, very good. A4 is 90 degree. Very good. It simply means that if angle between a line joining given point and a point on the given line is 90 degree, then the distance is shortest. If you go away from this point in either direction, upward or downward, then the angle here will go on decreasing. You studied applications of trigonometry. If you move away from any given point, then the angle between, which you call as angle of elevation, actually. The angle of elevation goes on decreasing, you have studied. So with decrease in angle of elevation, what happens to the distance? Distance goes on increasing. Distance goes on increasing. This is fact. What is this? This is fact. We will make use of this. A circle with center O and radius R. Tangent PQ drawn to the circle at point A. At point A. So for this, can we have a figure now? So a circle is given with center O. The radius of circle is are here. Good. So now what we have to prove? To prove OA perpendicular to PQ. If I join O to point A, then I have to prove that OA is perpendicular to PQ. Now let us consider one more point here. Say X. Let us consider one more point X. And join that also to O. Now how do you find OX comparing to OA? Longer, shorter, equal to? Can anyone tell me? This point is outside the circle. X is outside the circle, whereas A is on the circle. If we consider a point inside the circle, then that will be closer to center than OA and then OX. Is it right? So OX is longer than OA. Now if we start bringing this X towards A, you start moving this slowly, then what happens to OX? If you start moving down slowly, OX length will go on decreasing. The length of OX will go on decreasing. When it will be shortest? When X coincides with A, OX will become equal to OA, and that will be the shortest distance, because X will be lying on the circle. X will be lying on the circle. OX will then become equal to OA. If you cross A and then move further downward, again length of OX will go on increasing. Only at A you will find the shortest distance. So only for X at A, the length of OX will be equal to OA, and that will be the shortest length. Right? Proof. Consider another point X on PQ. Now X is outside the circle. Therefore, OX is longer than OA. OX is longer than OA. If X is moved, towards, if X is moved towards A, then as long as X does not coincide with E, that long OX will be greater than
OA.
Once X coincides with A, OA will be equal to OX the shortest distance between the shortest distance between center of circle and center of circle and X in bracket A, that means these two have coincided now. It is not X of A. What it is? X or A. When it is possible? Only when the two points have coincided. That is, OA perpendicular to PQ. Is it fact or not, which I taught earlier? Hence proved. So this is a simple theorem. And that is why by measuring angle between radius of circle and the tangent, we were giving justification to our construction in construction chapter. I hope you all remember. For giving justification, that is to say our construction is correct, we were measuring the angle between radius of the circle and tangent. So this theorem is reason for that.